Previously, I dared to question the work of a master of his field. I went up against Dan North, the originator, the father, the godfather of behaviour-driven development. And not in a small way, I questioned the canonical example of BDD, the infamous ATM example. Today, I'll eat a big, fat spoonful of humble pie. Welcome to Development That Pays. My name is Gary Strawn. I don't know how much you know about my move into IT. I used to have a proper job in industrial marketing, and I left it to join what we used to refer to as a dot-com. My transferable skill was project management, but my dot-com project management career lasted less than a fortnight. That's a thrilling tale that I'll save for another time. I lasted longer, years longer, in my next role as a business analyst, a role where I wrote a lot of functional specifications. A functional spec, as you may know, fits neatly into the space between the business requirements document and the systems requirements document. The three together answer the questions why, what, and how. Now, I understood that at an intellectual level, but in practice, I found it all too easy to stray from the what into the how. I hadn't realized just how bad my affliction was until I worked with one particular chap. He had his very own catchphrase. I might say something like, the user selects an option from a dropdown, and he'd chime in with, implementation detail. The user clicks, implementation detail. Damn, it was hard to get to the end of a sentence with this guy around. He was right, of course. There are many ways to skin a cat, and it wasn't our job to specify any of them. Trouble is, I quite like implementation details. Oh, that sounds a little bit weird. I'm not talking about skinning cats anymore. No, I'm interested in user interface design. I'm interested in usability. Steve Krug's book, Don't Make Me Think, is still one of my favorites. It's an interest that got me into trouble in my functional spec writing days, and it's still getting me into trouble today. Fast forward to the present day, and then rewind about 10 months. I borrowed a classic example from the godfather of BDD, Dan North, for one of my episodes. And for the longest time, no one batted an eyelid. And then they started to drip in. Comments to say that the sequence of events wasn't quite right. Here's one of the emails I received. See what he says? It's an example of bad usability. This got my Steve Krug Don't Make Me Think spidey sense tingling. A usability challenge. I love usability challenges. You ask for money, the card pops out, you grab the card and you walk away, leaving your money behind. Crazy. That's terrible usability. I suited up and I swung into action. You know what happened next. Last week's episode happened next. You know, the one where I said this was ever so slightly broken. I even went on to suggest some improvements. And then something else happened. Mike Jones left a comment. Now, Mike comments here reasonably often, and his comments are always good. Always. My first thought was, I wonder why he's left such a long comment. As I scanned it, one word jumped out at me from several places. Order. And in that moment, I knew I was in trouble. Without reading on, I went straight back to the classic example. Here it is, verbatim. Given the account is in credit and the card is valid and the dispenser contains cash, when the customer requests cash, then ensure the account is debited and ensure the cash is dispensed and ensure the card is returned. There's a high level order here. Of course there is. Context, event, outcomes. 1, 2, 3. But what about within each of those sections? The context is a list of things that must be true before we get started. They are descriptions of state rather than events. Now, this is a hugely important distinction. Events are slippery characters. Because an event changes the universe in some way, the order of events tends to be important. I put on my socks, I put on my shoes, works, whereas I put on my shoes, I put on my socks, doesn't. states are easier. The sky is blue, the sun is shining, the birds are singing. Order isn't important. And these statements had the same property. Given the account is in credit and the card is valid and the dispenser contains cash, those three statements could appear in any order. What about the event? Or is it events, plural? If we are dealing with more than one event, then the order of those events is likely to be important. But in this particular case, the ATM example, I couldn't seem to figure it out. Requesting cash is an event, removing the card is also an event. But what's the right order? It didn't help that there seemed to be different sequences of events out there in the real world. My cash machine requires that I move the card before the cash is dispensed. But you told me that it's common for the card to be returned at the end. And you also told me about the card dip, where withdrawing the card is one of the first things that happens. The answer to my conundrum was staring me in the face, but I couldn't quite see it. I went back and read Mike's post line by line and found this perfect sentence. The solution design of the user interface should be left open to the development team to implement in whatever innovative or minimal way possible, as long as the outcome meets desired behavior. This hit me like a slap across the ears. Implementation detail. The how, what, and when of the return and withdrawal of the card is an implementation detail. The important event is the request for cash. For the purposes of this scenario, it's the only event we need to care about. We've one more section to look at, the outcomes section, but just before we get there, a quick note that I have a cheat sheet for you. The TDD versus BDD cheat sheet. I put it together with the assistance of the Development That Pays community, and it details the key differences between TDD and BDD. You'll find a link to it in or around this video. Click the link, follow the instructions, and it's all yours. So yes, outcomes. Outcome debited, cash dispensed, card returned. Three events, right? I'm going to go out on a limb here and suggest that these are not events. When I borrowed this example for the cheat sheet I just told you about, I took the liberty of dropping the word ensure from the last three items. I now think that the word ensure is important. Ensure that the events have happened. If I'm right, and I'd love to hear your thoughts on this, this distinction means that we're not dealing with events, but states. Just to be clear, it's the difference between saying, I put on my socks, I put on my shoes, and saying, verify that my socks are on, verify that my shoes are on. Can you see that the first two have to happen in order and the second two could happen in any order? That's the difference between events and states. If we read these three lines as verify that the account has been debited, verify that the cash has been dispensed, verify that the card has been returned, we now have three statements that can be applied in any order. We've also handled the case that was driving me mad, the case of the card dip. At the end of the whole transaction, we verify that the card has been returned, and we find that it has. That it was returned quite a few steps earlier doesn't change that fact. That it was returned sometime earlier is just an implementation detail. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please click to like, share it with your network, and click the logo right here to subscribe for a brand new episode each and every Wednesday. I look forward to talking to you again soon. Cheers for now.